Welcome to the AEMC Model 6292 Micro-ohmmeter. This is part 2 of a 2-part video on the AEMC Model 6292. In part 1, we showed how to set up and run a basic test from the front panel controls and then store the results in memory. In this video, we will show you how to connect the instrument to DataView control panel, download the test stored in memory, and create a DataView report. The model 6292 communicates with the PC through a USB connection. Therefore, the first step is to connect the instrument to the PC by inserting one end of the supplied USB cable into the instrument front panel. The other end of the cable will go into an available USB slot on your PC. Once the device drivers successfully load, you'll be ready to connect through DataView. The latest version of DataView should be installed on the PC. During the installation procedure, the micro-ohmmeter option must be selected. This installs the micro-ohmmeter control panel and places its startup icon on the desktop. To begin the download procedure, click this icon to start the control panel. The control panel is the primary interface for connecting with the model 6292, downloading test results to the PC, and viewing the data on the screen. You can also use the control panel to set up tests on the instrument. First, we need to connect the PC to the model 6292. To do this, click Instrument in the control panel menu bar and then select the Connect option. The connection dialog box appears, which enables you to select the communication port, communication rate, and the instrument model. Click the Communication Port field to display a drop-down list of available ports and select the appropriate one. In our example, this is AEMC Model 6292. Next, select the communication rate. For the Model 6292, this is 57600. Finally, select the appropriate instrument model number, then click OK. After a few moments, the instrument should connect to the PC. When this is completed, the word connected appears in the lower right-hand corner of the control panel status bar, shown here. You can now download test results from the instrument to the PC. To do this, click Instrument on the menu bar and select Download. The Select Test dialog box now appears. This lists all tests currently stored in the instrument's memory. You can download individual tests by highlighting them, or use the Select All button to display the entire contents of the instrument's memory. In our example, there is only one test stored, so highlight it and click Download. The test results now appear in the navigation pane on the left side of the control panel window. This lists the object name as well as any tests contained within the object. As you will recall from our earlier video, we named our object Example 1, which currently has one test stored in it. Clicking on the name of the test displays its measurement data in the data pane on the right side of the control panel window, shown here. When first viewed, a test report can have a limited amount of information in the User, Site, and Test fields. You can add information by clicking Edit in the menu bar and selecting the Edit option. This will bring up the Session Summary Properties dialog box, which allows you to add more information. This dialog box consists of four tabs. The first is named Test, and it lets you enter additional information about the test. For example, you can enter a more meaningful name for the test. In our case, we are going to enter Example Test Number 1. Further below, you will find a description field. This is a one-line description of the test. Here we are going to put, this is the first test in example 1. Beneath that you will find a comments field. This is a freeform field which allows multiple lines of data or information. We are going to put, this is part of the instructional series for the model 6292 micro-ohmmeter. All of these additional descriptions and comments will be reflected on the cover sheet of the final DataView report. We will be generating a report for instructional purposes. You may be generating the report for customers, clients, management, or general documentation purposes as part of a preventative maintenance program. The Object tab lets you change the name of the object in which the test data is stored. In this case, we will leave the name of the object unchanged from the name we assigned in our earlier video, Example 1. The Operator tab enables you to enter information about the person who conducted the test. Initially, this tab is blank. To enter data, click the Edit button near the bottom of the screen. The Sessions Properties dialog box now appears. This has two tabs, Operator and Site. On the Operator tab, you can enter information about the person who conducted the test. You can also choose from a list of previously created operator records. For demonstration purposes, we earlier created records for three operators, which now appear in the list. When we select one, the person's information automatically populates the fields on this tab. When this tab is complete, click OK. The final tab in the Session Summary Properties dialog box is labeled Site. This lets you enter data about the location where the test was executed. When you click Edit to enter information into this tab, the Session Properties dialog box appears. Open the Site tab. As with the Operator tab, you can complete the displayed fields or choose an existing name from the site list. We have created an example site called Acme, so we will select it to automatically fill the remaining fields in the dialog box. We then click OK OK to populate the report with this information. You can now view the complete test record. This includes information about the test operator, the test site and location, the instrument model, and other test-related information. Finally, at the bottom is the test measurement data itself, as recorded on the Model 6292 instrument. To save the complete updated test on the computer, click File in the menu bar and select Save. You will be prompted to enter a file name for the saved test data. We will enter Example 1 Test, and this will be saved as an ICP file. You can now view the downloaded and edited test data as a DataView report. To do this, with the test selected, click File in the Control Panel menu bar and choose Create DataView Report. The report will open and display once it is created. By default, this report contains a cover sheet tab and a test summary tab. The cover sheet tab contains operator, site, date, and test instrument information. The test summary tab contains test results. To save the report to the PC, click File when viewing the report and then click Save and specify a location for the saved report file. Note that DataView includes a number of features that enable you to customize your reports, displaying your test results for a wide variety of users and purposes. These report generation features are described in detail in the DataView Help Manual. This video concludes our two-part series on setting up, downloading, and analyzing test results on the AEMC 6292.